So hello and greetings to the all the viewers. Today we will going to discuss about lifting analysis of horizontal pressure vessel using ANSYS workbench. So all of us know that once your vessel is designed and it's ready, then it is necessary to transfer that respective vessel to the site conditions. So during this transportation, we need to lift these vessels. So there might be different possibilities of the lifting, like where we design that vessel from there to when we going to dispatch or at the time of erection. So there might be different possibilities of lifting. So it is nowadays it is mandatory to do the lifting phenomena also. So one of the best tool is that finite element analysis. Is most of the industries nowadays are using to validate the structure for a different lifting configuration also. So we will see that in this video. Okay, then we will start now. Present the learnings in this video. First, we will see the small introduction to lifting phenomena of horizontal pressure vessel. Then we will move towards the lifting analysis of pressure vessels using ANSYS. So there are like three possibilities: lifting by 2 lugs, lifting by 4 lugs, and lifting of inclined vessel. So I had divided this in a 3 different configurations, or you can say the 3 different video I will going to create. So first video I will create for lifting by 2 lugs. Then we will create a video for lifting by 4 lugs and then lifting for an inclined vessel. And then we will see in this video like problem definition for a first case. Then we will move towards our actual ANSYS part. So these are the learnings in this video. Now we will see the lifting phenomena. When we talk about lifting by 2 lugs, you can see over here. So there are 2 possibilities, like this vessel is lifted by using lifting hook, which is this is nothing but your lifting chain, which is separated by using 60 degree angles. So this is the first phenomena, that is lifting by 2 lugs. And the similar to that, you can see it is also lifting by 2 lugs only. Only the difference between these two is that they had used the spreader bar. We can see this is what your spreader assembly. So between the hook and the lifting lugs. So this actually the images I have taken from this references, internet source references. If you want, you can go through that also. So this is the first case. The second case is like lifting by 4 lugs or lifting by 4 lugs by the help of hook. So you can see these are the 4 lifting lugs over here. And this is the actual lifting which is going to be happen at the site. Okay, so you can refer this reference. And this is the similar phenomena, another phenomena here. The difference only is that they had used the similar spreader bar, you can see over here. Okay, so lifting by 4 lugs with the help of spreader bar. And the next thing is that inclined lifting. So when we talk about the longer vessel, right, so you can see here it is one end. This is one crane and this is the another crane. So you can say parallel it will going to incline by some of the angles, like it will start from 0, then 30, 40, 45, 60 and 90, and later on it will be like vertical one. So during this lifting phenomena, there will be different types of loads which will going to come on this lifting lugs. So we will analyze that also. So these are the 3 different phenomena I had captured for a horizontal pressure vessel. Similarly, you can find for a vertical pressure vessel, but in case of vertical, there only be like top lifting will be the will be majorly used. Okay, so this slide represent the actual problem definition for this video. So you're like to carry out the lifting analysis of horizontal pressure vessel for its dead load. So you like this is what our first configuration, you can see here, this is what your horizontal pressure vessel, which is lifted by these two string, or you can say the lifting change, which are connected at the lifting hook. So this is the first minima. So this angle can be varied, like from 60 to 90 degree. When it is 90 degree, it will be like this. This is what your lifting hook and lifting chain, and this is your spreader beam apparatus, and this is what your actual vessel. So here the angle will be 90 degree. So we will try to simulate these two phenomena using ANSYS workbench. Then we'll move towards our actual ANSYS part. So now we will move towards our actual ANSYS part. Before proceeding, you just first cross check the units, whether you want SI or metric units or US customary or engineering units. I am keeping metric units. So based on that, you can select your units and then just drag and drop here, and first open your design model. So you can see this is what our horizontal vessel. You can import from here, like import external geometry file and give your respective local directory path. Okay, neither you can create this vessel using ANSYS design model itself. Okay, you can refer my previous videos so that you will get idea how to create a vessel. I had created that vessel here itself, but I just wanted to share here the lifting phenomena, so I will not going to cover these things. Okay, so this is what our vessel, which may consist of two lifting lugs. This is for your first and this is second lifting lug, right? And here you can see this is your shell, this is your shell part, and these are the heads, and these are supported on this side, and this is your manway nozzle. So you can create an imprint of that weld like this, right? Don't keep all this thing in a single part in design modeler except vessel, because here if you keep in a single part, what will happen, this pad will going to come in contact with this, and this will also going in contact with this. Here also weld will be there, but this is the smaller thicker portion, so that's why there is no need to create a weld. You can create a directly single part or bonded contact. But here your weld, the contact will going to happen through this weld surfaces only. Okay, so that's why you can keep all this in a separate parts, and then later on you can create a part between this body and this body, similar to this body to bottom body, right? So because here when it will going to lift from this, what will happen, there will not be direct contact between this. If it is connection, then the weld connection, the contact will going to happen through the welds. Okay, there is no direct contact will happen between these two body because we are lifting this from top side, right? So also you can create a small portion like this if you want to keep a finer mesh in this region. So you can create further one slice part, rectangular region. Okay, you just need to give the more concentration towards lifting lug, because here the main chances of failure is lifting lug. So similarly here also. Then we will quickly move towards our actual ANSYS part, mechanical window. I will double click and open that. So it will take some time. right? And this complete part you can keep in a single part. I had kept it bottom saddle part as a shell part just to reduce the mesh count. You can also do at your end if you don't want to simulate that bottom saddle part. So these are the shell parts while these are the solid parts, okay? And here it is, you can keep either solid only because weld modeling through solid. Here we had a model solid weld, so it is better to keep a solid parts only, all these things. So once it is done, you just first cross check your geometry panel. So you can see this is first, this is second, and these are our top parts. Then later on you can cross check your connections. Right now these are in different parts, so you need to define the connections over there, right? So first connection we will see, this is what bonded contact I had created between the top shells. You can see, so you can create a this bottom surface of this lifting lug and top surface of this pad, and you can create a contact like this. Similarly, you can create another contact at the weld surfaces. So if you see, this is what the weld bottom, weld inner faces, you can see over here. This is my weld inner face, and similarly if you look into this, this is my weld region. So like that you can create a weld patches or you can imprint in design modeler, and then you can create a contact between these two bodies, okay? And keep a solid contacts only, linear contacts that is bonded. Similarly for other lifting lug portion, I had created one contact. This is also another contact, you can see. And similarly here, as these are solid and shell parts, so you can create a contact here, saddle parts, right? Saddle bottom, you can imprint that saddle poses on the shell, and here in between these two saddles you can create a contact. So there will be like two contacts, and here two contacts, two and two, six. So total six contact will be there, 1 2 3 4 5 6, okay? The one, like, you can also compare physical way, like physically you can compare first, and then later on you can do the meshing. So here I had just kept it some of the coarse mesh because neither we could are not able to solve that. So here you can give the local meshing sizing for this. So even you can keep three elements across this lifting lug thickness. Here you can keep three elements. Here also you can make more finer so that stresses will be more, there will not be any singularity, right? So like that you can define a local. Here I had given like 8 mm size, so you can put 4 mm of size. Similarly on these welds also you can define a sizing, as well as face meshing also. If you want, you can define this face meshing so that there will not be any triangle, right? Here also you can see on the other sides. So like that you can create a mesh, and once your mesh is done, contact mesh is done, then you can define your loading conditions. So here the loads will be like, it is self-weight. So first cross check with your weight. Suppose your vessel weight, I will first keep here. I will first cross check the unit, structural steel 2. I will convert structural steel to this part, and this is structural steel. So if you see the complete weight here, I am open properties. So it is like 2.2082 tons, right? This is because of I had kept it some additional weight over here. If I will keep here in a structural steel, so you can see the difference now, 1.345 ton. I will make it in pounds so that Now it is 2985, and later on, once you will make it structural steel 2, it will become to 4868 pound, right? So this I had adjusted density for this structure. How to adjust that density, I will tell you. If you go to engineering data, right? So here, if you see the by default ANSYS may have and structural steel here, like density for structural steel like 7850, and here if you see the density I had increased. So you just calculate that from mass per unit volume. So the mass will be whatever the mass, if you want 2000, or so if you want 2 ton instead of 1 ton, then you can put that mass like 2000 kg, and you can keep the same volume for that respective vessel. Okay. So once it is done, then you can further go to once geometry is defined here, like the total mass of, you just cross check further, because it's the same, should we get the reactions. That is the way, 4868 pound nearly. Now we'll move towards our actual another loading part. So here if you see, first you can right click here, insert standard earth gravity, you can define, right? I had already defined here. So you can check minus x, you can change the direction here also from this, and you can cross check with the arrow which is displaying. Then that is done. Then you do one thing, you can create a remote point. So here I will tell you, first we need to do the some analytical calculations to calculate the 60 degree angle. So what I will do, I will go to Excel, right? But before Excel, you just cross check the distance, or you can measure that distance between two lugs. So I will measure distance. steps further, creating a remote point. So once your distance is determined, you just create one remote point over here between these two points. You can see I had created one remote point, and first of creating remote point, you just cross check, you just create first coordinate system. I will further create just to explain you how to create at that. Just select these two inner surfaces, extend to limit, you can keep. Similarly, you can select another surface, extend to limit, and just right click on a coordinate system, insert coordinate system. Okay, your coordinate is created. Now you can do one thing, you can shift that coordinate at a vertical height. Here go to and translate x direction. So we know the vertical height what we calculated, you just put that height. Okay, it is in inches, so you need to make it first unit mm, and then you can put over there. Okay, now you can see this is created at the 60 degree. So once it is done, you can create a remote point. I will tell you how to create. So two remote points we need to create at two ends. Insert remote point, and you can select these faces, extend to limit, apply, and you can give that coordinate system what we have created latest one. And here you can put 0 0, neither it will show at different distance. Okay, now you can see that remote point is created at this, and it is attached to that inner faces of this. Here one thing you need to keep in mind, here if you see, it is like inclined one, so complete face will not be in contact, so you can remove the sum of the face from this. So here I will be removing these faces, and I will be keeping, assuming that it will be come in contact with this much face only, because when it will going to be lift, so this portion will not be in contact, because your chain diameter will be smaller than this whole diameter, so it will be like over here, so this portion will be in contact. So you can create a split and you can mesh accordingly in design modeler that portion also. Similarly, you can create a remote point for this portion. Select these two faces, these are the two faces which will majorly come in contact. I am keeping additional these two faces. Insert remote point and give that coordinate system. And here you can keep 0. Okay. So now we can see here also it is created. So there are two remote points which are created. Now if you see, you can just right click in a and define remote displacement. Here define that remote point which we have created for, and here you can keep constant all degrees of freedom. Here it is one thing that I wanted to mention. If suppose in actual what will happen due to this lifting hook, there are some movements are allowed, like this trans moment along z axis, even moment along y axis. You can put that moment free also here, but I will recommend it to go with the worst case scenario. So worst case will be 0, so it will not allow you to move the if you keep some of the rotation free, then you will get more deformation, and also you will get less stresses. But if you keep all the degrees of freedom restricted, then you will get high stress. So it will be more conservative in case of FEA. Also, one more thing is that this line should be matched with the CG of this system. That is recommended. Suppose right now we haven't know what where exactly CG will lie. It will not exactly lie at the center of this. It will be somewhat ahead of this due to this weight of this, right? Then you need to just simply move this system to this at the CG locations. And even if you put the x direction constraint also, then only it can also be solved. and it will not show the rigid body motion. This is due to because we have created remote point at the CG location. Okay, so but I will not going to do that in much depth. So here it is also recommended you should not focus on this thing. You just keep the worst case scenario and just go ahead. Now this is first remote point. Similarly, you can create insert remote point for the another case. And similarly, you can define here all 0. All 6 degrees of freedom, I am keeping 0. So your deck is ready, right? So what we are doing right now, we are constraining this by all degrees of freedom, and we are just giving directional loads, that is standard gravity, in downward direction. So for that we will try to simulate this model. Okay, I will delete this and I will try to solve this. So what I will do, I will stop this solution because I am already having, so I will open that. So I will go to our ANSYS part. I will close this, and this is what the first model. Now there one more thing that I need to show you. If you see here, like when we have created remote point, there is one option is given at the bottom, whether you know how to define that remote points. If you see here these remote points, and if you go to bottom, you will find one option regarding behavior. You can keep either rigid, deformable, coupled or beam. So there is small difference between each and every term. Coupled is like it will directly couple with that element. That is not recommended most of the times. In thermal it will be helpful. Here rigid it means what, what are the degrees of freedom over here, it will directly translate to that face. And in case of deformable, you will find some of the deformation of this faces also, this face where you have connected. And the third term is like a beam. You can define the diameter and you can define the material also, right? Now first we will move to see the results for a rigid behavior. So what I will do, neither I will show you the difference between all these three terms. I will explain that. I will open paint. Just within 5 minutes I will explain. So first we will see what is the difference between rigid and deformable. So suppose this is what our first, this is our lifting lug, right? Here you can see, and I will just take a cross section and I will show you. Suppose you have created this rigid link over here, like this, right? What will happen in case of deformable? This face will not going to deform, this face, right? This will be constant. But when we talk about in case of rigidity will not deform, but when we talk about deformable, what will happen due to motion, this face will also deform. There is a you can see this is our initial position, and right now it is deformable. So you will get this much type of displacement, right? So this is the basic difference between rigid and deformable. And when we talk about beam, so what will happen, this links what we are connecting with the hook. So you can define the here phi cross section, like 10 mm, 20 mm kind of thing, right? So that is the third thing, that is beam. Okay, now we'll move towards our actual part. So here I have results for that. So we will see just quickly the deformation. So I will put undeform. So if you see here, the deformation I am getting like 13 mm, and if I will make it some of the scaled like 20, so you can see, right, how it is shifting. and I will keep wireframe on. So from this position it will be shifting to that. This is due to CD, right? And in actual also you will find when you will going to lift from this, it will be having some sort of movement over here. If you keep it like 40, right, it will be like that. And here it is rigid. So what we discuss, you can see we have connected this, so there will not be any deformation at this phase. So you will find somewhat higher stresses in this case. If you see the stress point of view, I will show you. What rigid links we need to prefer, whether we need to prefer rigids be aware or deformable. In case of deformable, these surfaces also will going to deform. In case of rigid, it will not going to deform. And you can see the stresses is almost similar to that. Here you will not find very high stresses. And if I will going to probe this, stresses will be almost same in both the cases at these locations. Same stresses I think we had seen there. So you can see here, right? And the third case will be your if you replace that by using beam elements. As we know that it will be having some lifting chain, so it may have some diameter. So you can also simulate that condition simply changing the behavior. So what I did, I had changed that to beam and I had given this 10 mm. You can see behavior as a rigid, and here structural steel by default, or you can define material reductive CP, and I had given a radius of 10 mm. So for that, if you see the deformation, so here you will find, see, these are the my rigid links, and here I am getting some of the deformation on higher side. This is due to, because in case of rigid, what will happen, whatever the degrees of freedom over here, it will be same applied over here, but here it will not be like that. This rigid beam will also have a degrees of freedom relax, so it will also going to be move. So that's why we are getting deformation on higher side, right? You can see over here, and stresses will be there will not be any change, or you can say this change will be like 2 to 3% change will be, but deformation point of view you will find some difference over there. So out of these three, you better way you can just consider coarse mesh, you just consider rigid link. So there you will get higher stresses, more conservative way, that is one of the shorter way to simulate that, and also reaction in all three cases will going to match, so there is no need to worry about that. Only the deformation will going to vary slightly in all three configuration. So this is what about the lifting by two lugs. So we'll move towards our actual PPT. So here the first case scenario we had finished. Later on you just cross check the stresses, you just do stress realization, but I will not going to cover that stress realization part because I had already covered. Now I will discuss the another thing, that is lifting by cable hoist. So I will double click that. So it is also similar to that, only here the small difference will come like creation of remote points. So in earlier case what we did, we had created remote point at the center locations. So here you just translate this coordinate system, you just create a this coordinate system, right, at this portion, and you just translate to that respective height. Similarly we can create a coordinate over here and translate to this respective height, and like that also you can create this remote point at the center and just give respective coordinate. Okay, so this is what your spreader bar, or you can say spreader link, and here at these two points you can fix instead of fixing at the center point, right? So if you compare with this, what we are doing, so I am also having a stress for this. I will just show you, this is what first remote displacement and this is another remote displacement. So if you see the deformation pattern for this, it will be like same deformation what we got there, 13 to 15 mm. I will make it 50. So if you, I will make it like this, see, it is also behaving the same. So